हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज नॉन होमोजेनियस लीनियर ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ हायर ऑर्डर विथ कांस्टेंट कोएफिशिएंट। ओके, सो एन ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ द फॉर्म ए जीरो डी रेस टू एन वाई अपॉन डी एक्स रेस टू एन प्लस ए वन डी रेस टू एन माइनस वाई अपॉन डी एक्स रेस टू एन माइनस वन प्लस ए टू d raised to n minus 2y upon dx raised to n minus 2 up to an y equal to qx. Your right hand side is q of x here. So, it is non-homogeneous. Where a0, a1, a2 up to an are constant is known as a non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation with constant coefficients. It can be write as a0 d raised to n plus a1 d raised to n minus 1 up to an, where y is equal to qx. F of d into y is equal to qx, where f of d is a0 d raised to n plus a1 d raised to n minus 1 up to an. As you know, here d is a differential operator, which is d by dx. This equation is known as non-homogeneous differential equation because its right hand side is non-zero. It is function of x. So, for the solution of this non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation, the general solution is complementary function plus particular integral. Short form is CF plus PI. We already learned about the homogeneous differential equation. If our given differential equation is homogeneous, then our general solution is only complementary function. But if our differential equation is non-homogeneous, then our general solution is complementary function plus particular integral. We already learned in our first lecture how to find complementary function. Now in this lecture we learn about the particular integral. So, direct method of obtaining particular integral, that is shortcut method. This method depends on the nature of qx. Qx, that is the right hand side of the non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation, which is in equation 1. See, this is our equation 1. So, it depends on the right hand side. Okay. The particular integral by this method can be obtained when qx has the following forms. See, these five forms given here. In today's lecture, we learn for case 1 and case 2. So, for case 1, when your right hand side q of x is equal to e raised to ax plus b, means exponential term is given on the right hand side, then for case 1, qx is equal to e raised to ax plus b. Then how to find the particular integral? For that, first your given non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation is function of d into y is equal to e raised to ax plus b. For solve particular integral or for finding particular integral, formula is 1 upon function of d, that is the multiple of y, into e raised to ax plus b. Then you have to substitute the multiple of x, the power of e, multiple of x, that is a, in the place of d, in function of d, in the place of d. But condition is f of a must not equal to 0. What if our denominator is 0? If f of a equal to 0, then put x in the numerator and the derivative of f dash, you have to do the derivative of f of d, that is f dash d, and in the equation in the form of f dash d, you have to substitute in the place of d a, that is x upon f dash a. Again, your condition is f dash a must not equal to 0. If again f dash a equal to 0, then multiply x with in the numerator, so the x into x, that is x square. Now second derivative f double dash d, now substitute in the second derivative of f of d, the place of d, the multiple of x is a. Again, f double dash a not equal to 0. You have to do the same till you get non-zero value in the denominator. This is the first case for find the particular integral. So, let's start with one example. D square plus 5d plus 6y is equal to e raised to x. Dear students, see, here your right hand side is non-zero, that is exponential term e raised to x. So you easily understand that this is your non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation with the first case e raised to ax plus b, right? For that, for the solution of this, let's start with the auxiliary equation m square plus 5m plus 6 is equal to 0. Now the factors are m plus 3, m plus 2 equal to 0. So roots are m is equal to minus 2 minus 3, which are real and distinct. So for the complementary function, as you know, both roots are real and distinct. So as per the rule of the complementary function of case 1, that is c1 e raised to minus 2x, c2 e raised to minus 3x. So one part is complete, complementary function. But for PI, for particular integral, 1 upon function of d into e raised to ax plus b. What is our function of d? Our function of d is multiple of y, that is d square plus 5d plus 6. And your right hand side q of x is e raised to x. Okay. Now, as per the rule, the multiple of x is 1. So, substitute 1 in the place of d in the denominator. So, we get 1 upon 1 square plus 5 into 1 plus 6, that is 12, which is non-zero. So, e raised to x by 12, this is our PI, particular integral. So, the general solution is y is equal to CF, complementary function, plus PI. So, this is our complementary function plus particular integral. So, for the non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation, our solution, general solution is CF plus PI. This is our final answer for the given example. For one more example, solve 4d square minus 4d plus 1 into y is equal to e raised to x by 2. Dear students, here your right hand side is in the exponential term, which is not equal to 0. So, let's start with the solution. Your auxiliary equation is 4m square minus 4m plus 1 equal to 0. Okay. So, the factors are 2m minus 1 into 2m minus 1, that is 2m minus 1 whole square is equal to 0. And the roots are m is equal to 1/2, 1/2, which is real and repeated. And as per the complementary functions, case 2, real and repeated root, your complementary function is c1 plus c2x into e raised to x by 2. So, for the second part, PI, 1 upon function of d into your right hand side, q of x, that is e raised to x by 2. So, your multiple of x is 1/2. So, you have to place 1/2 in the place of d in the denominator. But, if 1/2 square, so 4 by 4, which is 1, 1/2, that is minus 2 and 1. 1 plus 1 and minus 2. If we place 1/2 in the place of d here, we get the 0 in the denominator. So, as per the rule, you have to write x and the derivative of the denominator, that is 8d minus 4 into e raised to x by 2. Now, you have to substitute your multiple of x in the place of d. So, multiple of x is 1/2. If we place here 1/2, that is 4 minus 4. Again, we get 0. So, as per the rule, x into x, that is x square, and the derivative of this denominator is 8 e raised to x by 2, which is non-zero. So, this is our final particular integral, and general solution is complementary function plus particular integral for this example. Okay. Let's start with one more example. d square plus 6d plus 9y is equal to 5 raised to x minus log 2. See, this is again non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation. But in the right side, we didn't find the exponential term. Okay, so what? Okay, let's check. See, this is our homogeneous, this is our auxiliary equation, m square plus 6m plus 9 equal to 0. So roots are m plus 3, factors are m plus 3, the whole square equal to 0. So the roots is m equal to minus 3 minus 3, which is real and repeated. And as the case 2 of complementary function for real and repeated root, we can write here c1 plus c2x into e raised to the minus 3x, because both root are repeated. For the second part, particular integral, 1 upon d square plus 6d plus 9, which is the function of d, that is the multiple of y, and your right hand side q of x, that is 5 raised to x minus log 2. So we write here 5 raised to x in the form of e raised to log 5 raised to x. Okay, and e raised to log 5 raised to x and 5 raised to x, both are same. So e raised to log 5 raised to x upon d plus 3 whole square. So because d square plus 6d plus 9, we can write d plus 3 the whole square, and minus log 2 upon again d plus 3 the whole square. So as per the rule of the logarithm, we write x in the multiple of x. So e raised to x log 5, and log 2 is a constant term. We represent at e raised to 0, log 2 into e raised to 0 x. So both are same, there is no change in the value. Okay, so e raised to ax. Okay, so e raised to x, now the multiple of x is log 5, so you have to substitute log 5 in the place of d in the denominator. Similarly, here the multiple of x is 0, so you have to place 0 in the place of d in the denominator. So after placing log 5 in the denominator and after placing log d 0 in the denominator, we get log 5 plus 3 whole square e raised to x log 5, same 0 plus 3 whole square log 2 e raised to 0 x. So 0 plus 3 is 3, 3 square is 9. So after simplifying, 5 raised to x log 5 plus 3 the whole square minus log 2 by 9. So general solution, y is complementary function cf plus pi. Okay, so let's one more example. For the case 1, for finding particular integral, d cube y upon dx cube plus 8y is equal to cos hyperbolic 2x. We represent d by dx as a differential operator, d cube plus 8, here y is common, and cos hyperbolic 2x, that is e raised to 2x plus e raised to minus 2x by 2. Our auxiliary equation is m cube plus 8 equal to 0. The factors are m plus 2, m square minus 2m plus 4 equal to 0. So the roots are m is equal to minus 2, and the root for the m square minus 2m plus 4 equal to 0 is 2 plus or minus under root 4 minus 16 by 2. By simplifying, we get final root 1 plus or minus I root 3, which is complex. Okay, so here power is 3, so we get total 3 roots, 1 real root minus 2 and 2 complex roots, 1 plus I root 3 and 1 minus I root 3. And as per the rule of complementary functions, here c1 e raised to minus 2x plus, here this is minus 2, so c1 e raised to minus 2x, and for the complex root your real part is 1, so e raised to 1x, so only e raised to x. And c2 cos imaginary part, that is c2 cos root 3x plus c3 sin root 3x. Okay, so this is the first part for the examples, complementary function for particular integral, 1 upon function of d, that is multiple of y, into b the right hand side. Okay, 2 common, so e raised to 2x upon d cube plus 8 plus e raised to minus 2x upon d cube plus 8. Here the multiple of x is 2, so if we substitute 2 in the place of d, that is 2 cube 8 plus 8, which is 16. But if we replace minus 2 in the place of d, that is minus 8 minus 2 cube, that is minus 8. Minus 8 plus 8 is 0. So we write here x, and the derivative of the denominator is 3d square. So if we substitute minus 2 in the place of d, that is minus 2 square, that is 4. 4 plus 4 into 3 is 12. Okay, minus 2 square, so 12. And here 2 cube plus 8, which is 16. So by simplifying, this is our final particular integral. And for the general solution, complementary function CF plus particular integral, this is our general solution for the given problem. Okay, for case 2, if our right hand side in the form of sin AX plus B or cos AX plus B, okay, then this is our non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation, function of dy, and your right hand side is sin AX plus B or cos AX plus B. For find particular integral in the form of for f of d square, where your function of d, and in function of d, whenever you get d square term, then you replace in the place of d multiple of x, that is a, in the place of d square of d, and put minus sign. Okay, your condition is f of minus a square, which must not equal to 0. If it is equal to 0, put x and the derivative of this equation, and in the derivative of this, again you have to put in the place of d a. Again, condition is denominator must not equal to 0. Similarly, go till your denominator is non-zero. Okay, let's start with example. Your given equation is d square plus 3d plus 2y equal to sin x. Your auxiliary equation is m square plus 3m plus 2 equal to 0. So the factors are m plus 2, m plus 1 equal to 0. So roots are m is equal to minus 1, minus 2. Both are real and distinct. So CF is c1 e raised to minus x plus c2 e raised to minus 2x. For particular integral, 1 upon function of d into the right hand side, that is sin 2x. Okay, so as per the rule, in the function of d, when you get the term d square, you have to substitute the multiple of x, that is 2 square, and put minus sign. Okay, so after simplifying, we get 1 upon 3d minus 2. For more, we have to get conjugate 3d plus 2 and 3d plus 2 in numerator and denominator. After simplifying, we get 3d plus 2 upon 9d square minus 4 into sin 2x. Now, in the place of d square of d, you have to substitute 2 in the place of this d, put minus sign in front of that. So, after simplifying, that is, see, this minus sign is in the this is 2 square only. So 2 square, 9 fours are 36, and this minus sign is out of this bracket. So this is minus 36 and minus 4, this is minus 40. Okay, now if we 3d into sin 2x and 2 into sin 2x, so d of sin 2x, that is the derivative of sin 2x. So sin 2x is derivative of sin 2x is 2 cos 2x, and after simplifying, we get this the final particular integral, and your general solution is complementary function plus particular integral. For this example, d square plus 6d plus 8 into y is equal to cos square x. Your auxiliary equation is m square plus 6m plus 8 equal to 0. Factors are m plus 4 into m plus 2 equal to 0. Roots are m is equal to minus 4 minus 2, real and distinct. So your complementary function is c1 e raised to minus 4x plus c2 e raised to minus 2x. For particular integral, 1 upon function of d into right hand side, that is cos square x. Formula for cos square x is 1 plus cos 2x by 2, because there is no shortcut method for solving this form, cos square power of cos or sine more than 1. For this, here 2 common, 1 upon d square plus 6d plus 8 and cos 2x upon d square plus 6d plus 8. Here 1 is constant, so we can write 1 into e raised to 0x. So as per the case 1, we have to substitute 0 in the place of d. So 0 squared, that is 0 plus 0 plus 8, so 1 by 8. And for case 2, for particular integral cos 2x, we have to substitute here 2 square and minus sign. So minus 4 plus 6d plus 8. Okay. So 6d plus 4, after simplifying, 6d minus 4 upon 6d minus 4. I forgot to put the bracket here. So this is the conjugate. After simplifying, 6d minus 4 upon 6d minus 4, 6d plus 4 is a minus b, a square plus b, that is a square minus b square. So you substitute 2 in the place of d. 2 square minus sign is out of the in front of the 36. So by simplifying, we get minus 160 cos 2x. Now 6d into cos 2x and minus 4 cos 2x. Derivative of cos 2x is minus 2 sin 2x. 2 into 6, that is minus 12. Okay, minus. But if we get 2 common and cut here, so 1 by 16, and here 2 common and cut, so 3 sin 2x plus 2 cos 2x. Here if we get minus common, so minus minus plus. So this is the general solution for complementary function, for complementary function and particular integral. One more example, that is d square y upon dx square minus 6dy by dx plus 9y is equal to cos 2x sin x. So here multiply by 2 and divide by 2. Here 2cs formula, so that is s minus s, that is sin 3x minus sin x. Our auxiliary equation is m square minus 6m plus 9 equal to 0. Factors are m minus 3, m minus 3. So roots are m is equal to 3, 3 real and repeated. And for particular integral, this 1 upon function of d, and your right hand side we put 2 here, and sin 3x minus sin x. So sin 3x upon d square minus 6d plus 9, and sin x upon again d square minus 6d plus 9. As per case 2, we apply multiple of x, that is 3, in the place of d square of d, 3 and minus sign in front of that. For both case, and here the multiple of x is 1, so you have to substitute 1 in the place of d square of d and put minus sign in front of that. So minus 9 minus 6d plus 9, and here minus 1 minus 6d plus 9. By simplifying, we get sin 3x upon minus 6d, and here sin x upon 8 minus 6d. Here just 1 upon d, see this is the constant, so minus 6 into d, so minus 1 upon 6, and here d is, so 1 upon d is the integration form, so 1 upon d minus 1 by 6, and 1 upon d is integration, so integration of sin 3x with respect to x. Here 8 minus 6d, so we again take conjugate, 8 plus 6d upon 8 plus 6d. Again, I forgot to put the bracket here. By simplifying this, here the integration of sin 3x is minus cos 3x upon 3. And by simplifying this, we get 8 plus 6d upon 64 minus 36d square sin x. You have to substitute 1 in the place of this d square. 1 square, that is 1, and minus sign, so minus minus plus. By simplifying, we get 4 here. 4 plus 3d upon 64 plus 36 into sine 3x. So this is 4 sine x plus 3d of sine x. D of sine x, that is derivative of sine x, is cos x. So this is our final particular integral. And the general solution is complementary function plus particular integral. Student, thank you so much. In today's lecture, we learn for case 1 and case 2 for the particular integral. And in the next lecture, we learn for case 3, 4 and 5. Feel free to contact me if you have any problem to understand it. Okay, thank you.